Okay, so why can't you read the robotics papers? And that's because you never played a game. So when we play these kind of games like this, we need to practice the combo keys. The combo keys are the secrets to use the skills to control your character. And this is why I was unable to read the academic papers at the beginning. If you feel like you are also unfamiliar with the combo keys in robotics engineering, let's discuss. Even if you're a pro, let's still discuss. Oh, and if you're new to here, my name is Elliot. I'm a robotics engineer, educator, and entrepreneur providing the relevant services. If you have ever played a video games, of course you have. You might have encountered stages like endless Goombas coming out, or sometimes you need to hunt Baron Nashor with your team, and then you failed and then blame with each other, and then go to internet community to see how others tackle this Baron thing, like what kind of combos they use for Master E or Cat, and then what kind of strategies they used as a team. And the interesting thing is that the researchers are doing the same thing. They share how they tackled the big problem, what kind of combo keys and what kind of strategies they used. And then it turned out to be, if this problem happened to be really large and good for humanity, they win the Nobel Prize. And of course, I'm not talking about Nobel Prize here. Instead, I'm just trying to let you taste the game of robotics engineering, or say the game of drone. For example, this is one of the legendary research paper in autonomous navigation, especially for visual inertial audiometry. And I know, please don't leave me or don't unsubscribe me, because I'm not really deep diving this paper today. Instead, I just want a little bit of a taste how these research papers and textbooks could be potentially turned into your cookbooks. And this paper is talking about the rotation, and the rotation is a big problem in robotics for whatever projects like autonomous drone, airplane, cars, or robot arms. The rotation is a big issue because, for example, if it's a robot arm, you need to control the arm angle of the robot, but the angle is off, then your robot arm cannot grab the stuff. So the rotation information for autonomous navigation, for autonomous drones, is a really, really important information. And this paper is talking about that. And again, I understand it doesn't look like the stories of how to get the barrels and so on, but it is composed of all the combos they are using. Then they're talking about their strategies to solve this rotation problem. And again, if you still don't see it, and that's because you never played a game. So let's play the game. So when I mention rotation, it is the rotation that everyone knows. You don't have to be an engineer to understand what's the rotation. Here's an airplane. If you toggle show stays, it's going to show stays of this airplane, Euler angles, angular velocity. And in real life, we don't have Euler angle information from the sensors. And I just have it because it's just a game engine based physics, right? So I know the answer from the game engine, but in real life, we don't have it as a robotics engineer. Now, let me slide this thing, and that will just x-axis rotation speed, and then it will follow the sine wave to change the rotation speed. And as you can see, angular velocity here is changing along with the x-axis, and then the corresponding Euler angle for x-axis is changing in degrees. And that's the rotation, that's what I mean by that. And then it looks like, what's the problem with that, right? And for now, just let's really quickly change the gear a little bit to look at the textbook, which is flight dynamics here. As you can see from the textbook, there are the angles defined for X, Y, Z axis, which is vehicle bank, pitch, heading angles. And then down there, they are talking about the rotation matrix that you can just plug in these numbers and then create a matrix and then multiply them like this. And then you're going to end up with this kind of rotation matrix. Cool. Awesome. So what's the deal, Elia, right? Problem is the actual sensors like this. This will be mounted on your robot arm or drone and car and whatever that is. This is the typical sensor that you'll be using for your rotation. Then this tiny chip here is the inertial sensors. And inside of this tiny chip, there are three sensors called magnetometer to measure the magnetic field of the Earth. Another one is accelerometer that measures all this acceleration on this body of this chip along with this Y, X, and Z axis here. And then the last sensor is a gyroscope, which measures the angular velocity. This is the gap I'm talking about. Unlike the textbook, this sensor doesn't give me any information about Euler angles and rotation matrix. So how do you do it? You can't even have Euler angles from the first spot. So the rule to win this rotation game in the game of, say, game of drone, you need to figure out the Euler angles or rotation matrix that the textbook described. because the textbook is definitely correct. It is just missing the practical points. And now, this is time to use the combo keys to fill the gaps. So if you have been listening to me, you must be asking Elliot, the gyroscope gives the angular velocity anyway, then why don't you just integrate them? Perfect, if you really asked this question in your mind, please comment down below because it means you are really, really thinking and listening to me. Now, the answer to that is unfortunately that's not straightforward for the 3D rotation. And here's why. Let me just reset everything. I'll just turn on the x-axis rotation, and then I'll turn on the y-axis rotation. And the angular velocity for x and y are changing, but the z-axis angular velocity is zero because I never turned this on. Now, the really weird thing is these Euler angles that we never turned on the angular velocity for z-axis. As you can see, it's always zero, but the z-axis Euler angles, it is changing with x and y axis. And then people call this is a non-linearity of the rotation. And this is the level one boss to kill. Then it's time to use the combo. And this is not the error from the game engine. It's actually the actual physical phenomenon of the physics engine of this universe. And as more detail, it's actually the definition of the Euler angles. So it's more like a problem of the human languages. And if I may add a little bit more, this angular velocity information is coming from the linear phenomenon, because linear means it's easy to understand and non-linear means not easy to understand. So before we talk about combo keys, let me review the entire map of the non-linear rotation, which is the entire view of this level one boss. So in the textbook, we know there is a rotation matrix in chapter one and Euler angles as well. And then in reality, with your Arduino and the wires all together, you have this sensor. And then you just Google Arduino script for MPU 6050. There is tons of code that you can read the sensor data. And that is only angular velocity. Then the real problem for the beginners, they are left alone on this part because they don't know how to connect angular velocity to one of the concepts in the textbook. And the combo keys that I'm talking about is one of these arrows. In this case, this red arrow is called exponential map. And it looks like this. I know, I don't try to understand. I'm just showing you there is the equation that you can just plug in the numbers to get the rotation matrix. This is just how the code implementation looks like in Python. It's just really a few lines of code. It's really trivial in a way, but this field is really not kind enough to the beginners, so they don't just show you this trivial code to do the simple things for your actual robot. So if I go back to the paper again, this first paper, another misleading convention of this academia is the figures like this, and they call this curved surface as non-linear phenomenon like I showed you, and that phenomenon is represented as this curved surface. And then the flat surface is the linear information like the angular velocity. And when I first saw this kind of convention or diagram, I was like, is it talking about flat earth theory and then earth is not flat and it's actually curved? No, it's not. It's just the phenomenon that I just showed you with the simulation. That's it. And that's what I mean by the phenomenon first, experience the game. Then you will understand this paper. For example, they're just talking about this symmetric matrix, which is this skew symmetric matrix that I just showed you, that you can just plug in the X, Y, and Z angular velocity from your sensor. Just plug in there. And this paper is talking about that. So what they are doing here is that they are defining this combo keys that they will be using for the rest of the paper. And then they are just using these combo keys again and again. So if you didn't understand the details, it's normal because I never discussed the details of the rotation in mathematical sense. Instead, I really wished you have now a new perspective about these research papers, and it's just really like a game community where people share their strategy and combo keys with others. Well, if you agree or can't agree with this, please share your thoughts by commenting down below. And if you think this kind of contents are helpful, please don't forget to like the video and subscribe to this channel. My name is Elliot, and I'll see you around.